nice to see more smiles today. Well, because yesterday you were just a little bit recovering after the flight. Yes, yeah, but I can see more smiles, which is very good. And we will do plenty of practical exercises today. I imagine you put your data, your national data, your local data, your university data, and also, you, I don't know, but you remember that one of the targets, one of the goals of the project was to create a strategic plan, and you were about to develop a strategic plan. I don't know whether you have the strategic plan. Can you raise your hands who has the strategic plan? Who has developed the strategic plan? For the project, for the project. And who is in the process of developing this strategy?
Now all your hands should go up.
Yeah, who is in the process? Yes, process, yes, yeah. Okay, so you are in the process of developing strategic plan and specifically on university enterprise, okay? So you are developing this. And today we will do the introduction. We will first look at strategic planning. What is it? How do we do this? We will look at the steps and we will see how we can, and we will do some practical exercises as we go. And we will do it together with European colleagues, and you will decide whether you want to do it within your university or within your country. And then we will do short presentations of what we have achieved. Are you happy with this? Yes, okay. So, strategic planning. And I have questions. You know that I like questions. So we have questions today. When did strategic planning in higher education emerge? And why did they invent strategic planning for higher education? What were the challenges in developing strategic planning in higher education? Or what are the challenges? And what is strategic planning? So who can answer all these questions? You will get a prize. any question you can ask? No, earlier. Earlier. It came up earlier, okay. 70s and 80s. When they started the first strategic plans. But what are the challenges in developing strategic plans? What do you say? And what is strategic planning? What is it? What did they ask you to do? They asked you to complete your strategic plans in university enterprise, I think by the end of March. Yeah. You had to do the strategic plans according to the goals of the project. Yeah. Well, the coordinator is not here. So, what is strategic plan? And what is strategic planning? And what is strategic plan? What is this? It's a plan, yeah?
It's a plan. It's a plan of the place of one. We have to accomplish. We have to do to accomplish the goal.
Yes, what we have to do to accomplish the goal. But what will strategic plan will include at the university level? Okay. Okay, well, let's see. So, as I said, 70s, 80s, and what happened at that time in the States and in Europe, the enrollments began to fluctuate. You know, sometimes they have students, sometimes they had little students, so, or depends on the specialist. In some specialism, there were less students, and the others, there were more. And the university authorities had to do something. Then student demographics began to change. And it was not only, I think in those, at the end of the 70s, there were more and more students coming of like older students who decided to have a second degree, and that's when it started. And the funding, and that's the you remember yesterday we discussed about resources, and you were saying that resources is very important, and then the funding became inconsistent. So, well, to speak clearly about this, the funding was cut to many universities, and that's where the cut started in the 70s and 80s, and the universities had to deal with this. And strategic planning was a solution for developing some sort of proactive stance in the environment, in that environment when everything changed, and the demands changed, and the resources declined, they go down. So less resources, and the university had to deal with this. And there were challenges as well, and there are challenges. And the one is, of course, how to convert corporate strategies. Because when we talk about strategic planning, initially in those times, well, it was mostly prerogative of business companies, organizations like corporate organizations. And then suddenly, they wanted to bring this culture, this corporate culture, to universities. Because they wanted to deal with those issues, which are like recruiters. So it was quite daunting to convert the strategies, the corporate strategies, for the university. And it was not easy, because you can't do the same strategy for a company and a university. These are two different organizations, so you had to change it significantly. And they wanted to adapt the process designed to motivate assessment-based change. So, the change morning, the change is important. And to implement that change within a short period of time was frustrating and ineffective. Okay, that's so nice to see. There should be. So at that time it was, and we are talking about 70s and 80s, when they were trying to use the strategic planning for universities, it was quite difficult and sometimes ineffective because they didn't know how to apply strategic planning for universities. And the problem was as well that there was very little data. At that time, universities didn't keep so much data as we keep now. The students were coming and the university didn't process the data at that time. So they didn't know how the students were performing. And that was another challenge for the universities because there was not enough data. So, and if they didn't know enough data, they didn't know how to develop a strategic plan. So it was all interconnected. And of course, the strategic planning was used by the academics, that this was actually infringing the institutional or university freedoms and university's role. So it was different culturally to universities to have a strategic planning. So there was some sort of opposition to strategic planning. And the strategic planning also didn't motivate staff. And there was no understanding among staff that what strategic planning is. And this is very important, that if there is a strategic plan, if you are developing a strategic plan, you need to have the university, all the staff, understanding the strategic goals, understanding where the university is going. So all the staff, students, they have to be on board. They have to be with you when you are developing strategic plan. If you don't take the staff with you in developing strategic plan won't work. It will stay on paper and that's it. It is a good thing to have a strategic plan, but it won't work. So that's what the other thing which you need to think, how to take your staff on board, that they understand that that's what you want to achieve. So, obviously, we are always asking, what is the institution? What is your university? What does it do and why? And what does it want to do in the future? These are the questions you need to ask yourselves. And this is the questions you will have answers. You need to have answers in your strategic planning. So what is the institution? What does it do and why? And what does it want to do in the future? So these three questions, and thinking about this, I want you now to think about it because we will start discussing it very soon. But these three questions are important. And think about your institution. And to attain the target through the adaptation of competitive conditions of globalization, globalizing world, and systematization of how to attain the targets. So we are in the globalizing world, we have a competition, and we all have competitions, all universities compete. And how you will attain the targets, achieve those targets, if you have the strategy. So strategic planning, in fact, involves identification. So you identify the goals, implementation, how will you implement, how will you introduce them, this change, and monitor. So you're monitoring, you're thinking of, how will I monitor, how will I know that have we achieved this goal? And these positions, identification, implementation, and monitoring, they will define the behavior of institutions, especially when the situation is changing. And now the situation is changing so fast in all countries around the world. And we need to do something about it. So, strategic planning has these three, four items. It identifies the future. Identifies the future while analyzing the present situation. You will have all the slides to you. They will be sent to you. Don't worry. So you need to analyze the present situation and identify the future. And then you set up the targets which you want to attain in the future. You need to identify how it will be, how it will attain these targets, and the effective and efficient use of resources. Because you always think about, okay, we want to create the best school and build 10 buildings, but you don't have resources. How would you put this in your strategic plan? So you need to think about that it has to be realistic. You can't put something which you know you won't be able to achieve. How will you achieve it? So strategic planning, it is the planning which generates future mission of the university, a vision of the institution in a dynamic environment and changing surrounding. So that's the definition. This is one of the definitions, of course. But this is the definition of strategic planning. And that what we discussed a minute ago, determining strategic objectives and measurable targets. And this word measurable is important. It has to be measurable. This has to be smart targets. So, which will measure the performance, predetermined indicators, you will identify the indicators, and you know them, that you need to identify the indicators, and monitor and evaluate the process. You stop me, because I don't. And that's what I discussed, I mentioned to you, that participative approach is extremely important. You need to take them on board. You can't create here, for example, in your little group, a strategic plan and publish it. It won't work. You need to go out to your colleagues and students and all and employers maybe, involved employers, that this is the strategic planning we are thinking about at the university. So what do you think? Get their views. And if you take them on board, if you make them interested in this, it will work. You will achieve the target. But if you're not taking them on board, it won't work. So strategic management is management of the decisions and activities which define a long-run performance. I simply give you a few definitions here. And here, McNamara says, define strategic planning as determining where the organization will be next year or the following years, how they will go there, and whether it will go there or not. Which definition do you want? Why?
Sugar. Why? It's the first thing, yes. It's a precise
answer. Yes. Yeah, it's precise. Yes.
My meaning is, theme is same. Maybe part difference, but logic is the same.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, more or less.
It's logic is same. Language only difference.
Uh-huh. Yeah, only the language. Okay. So we are coming to a very important thing. Do you know about SWOT?
Yes.
What is it? What is it? Tell me. Yes.
It's a model to analyze.
Can you say aloud a little bit so everyone could hear?
It's a model to analyze the PowerPoint of the computer of the company or corporations or organizations, includes strength and weakness. Weaknesses in the internal company organizations, and opportunities and threats in the external environment to bring for company or enterprises.
For companies and enterprises.
And organizations.
An organization.
It will be represent our current situation. Organization situation.
Yes. Yeah, so yes, that's right. So we want to see where we are. And you said it is for companies. Yes? Can we apply this for universities?
Yes.
Uh-huh. As an organization. Yeah. Okay. Good. Good. And can you see it here? I think this slide is not. So here we're identifying as here. You can see we're identifying strengths. How do you do and what do you do to to do better? Or would you do better than the others? What are the unique capabilities? And what do other perceive as your strengths? So here you are talking about strengths. Here we are talking about weaknesses. So identifying what are your weaknesses in your university. What do your competitors do better? So you always benchmark yourself. You know benchmark, yes? Yeah. So you always think about your competitors. What do they do better here? What can you do to improve the current and would you other perceive as your witnesses? And opportunities, obviously, you can see what trends or conditions may positively impact you. So you need to think about trends, conditions, and which create opportunities. And what are opportunities available for your university? And obviously we are talking about threats and what trends or conditions may negatively impact your university. What's happening which may create negative conditions and your university won't be able to do something. What your competitors do which may impact. And do you have financial support? And do you have enough financial support? Or maybe there will be no financial support. and what impact it has, and what impact do your weaknesses have on the strategy? So these are the threats. And what we will try to do now, do you have pieces of paper? So what we want to do, we want you to work, we're thinking about whether you work in as one university, or whether you want to work as one country. No, that's fine. You will need it. So we will work in groups now, either university by university, or country by country. You need to decide. And what we want you to do, we want you to do the SWOT analysis of your university. Perhaps you can do it by university. I think that will be easier. Because you don't want to speak to your competitor. Although we are all partners here. You will try to put bullet points. Like bullet points, just a few, like identify strengths, identify which your opportunities may be, or weaknesses. So strengths, start here from strengths and weaknesses, and then go into opportunities and what the threats are in your situation. They will bring paper in a second, and I will ask our European colleagues to spread around and work with one of the university if you can. You can move chairs and you can sort of sit around the table. So, and we will give like 20 minutes for this. So when is the coffee break? So maybe we'll finish and then I'll have to break in the room. So what we will do, it's almost 10 o'clock, we'll give you 20 minutes, so you will do group discussions for 20 minutes, then we will do a coffee break, and then we will come from the coffee break, and you will we will ask each group to report briefly, because you will have only the bullet points. Because it will be good for us to establish what strengths, what weaknesses, and obviously opportunities and threats, so that we can go move on to a strategic plan developing strategic plan later on. Will it be okay? Yeah, Joe.
So can I just clarify, asking partners to work on a SWOT analysis with respect to employability and exercise? Not generally.
Thank you, Joe, that's very important. Yeah, we're talking about university enterprise or employability, yes? Because the strategic plan is for university enterprise. So that's why you are thinking about employability or university enterprise. Okay, well, so if you could, I imagine you have pieces of paper, but if no, Tuck will bring in a second. So could you arrange yourself that you sit like one university sit together?